Now, I know what you're thinking. How can a corbel, an old stone head stuck up in the roof of Westminster Abbey, really get to see everything that goes on below? Well, I have been up here for hundreds of years, and I can't help but feel I still have a few hundred years ahead of me. I get to see coronations, state funerals, celebrations and christenings, but there's nothing quite as touching as weddings at Westminster Abbey, particularly when it's royalty getting married. Just look at this grand piece of paper with squiggly writing. This is the marriage license of Prince William and Catherine Middleton when they got married in 2011. Just one of those little details you have at every wedding but might just miss, unless you're a corbel, of course. I spot all those little details. Like flowers, for example. Did you know that your choice of wedding flowers is really important? When Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip married in 1947, orange blossom featured on the hem of the Queen's dress. And when the Queen Mother married in 1923, she also had a bouquet which featured plenty of orange blossom. And if we rewind even further in time and go back another 80 years, you have Prince Albert giving his wife, Queen Victoria, a brooch of, you guessed it, orange blossom, to celebrate their wedding anniversary. What's the fuss with orange blossom? Well, they say orange blossom brings good luck, good health, and is also a sign for eternal love. Aww. It's not just what kind of flowers is important in weddings. At the Abbey, it's also important what you do with them. This here is the grave of the unknown warrior, the resting place of a British soldier from the First World War. We don't know who he is, and so, in a strange kind of way, this means he stands for all those soldiers who were lost in that terrible war. You might recognise the flowers placed round the grave. They're poppies, the flower of remembrance. But when we have a royal wedding at the Abbey, another flower is placed on his grave. You see, when the Queen Mother got married in 1923, she made sure her wedding bouquet was laid at the grave of the unknown warrior. At the time, people thought it a bit strange, but they didn't know that the Queen Mother's brother, Fergus, died in the First World War. It was her way of honouring his memory. And ever since that time, royal brides have done the same. Another detail I always look out for is the wedding ring. It's the thing that links the Queen Mother, Queen Elizabeth II, Princess Margaret, Princess Anne, and Diana, Princess of Wales. You see, those rings were made from a single nugget of Welsh gold. That's a lot of rings. And even though that nugget has barely any gold left in it, you'll be happy to know the Queen has been presented with a brand new nugget of gold for future royal weddings. So, one thing we can be sure of, there'll be plenty more royal weddings here at the Abbey. Hooray! Here comes the bride. Dum dum dee da. Doo 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 doo.